Thank you for joining me today. My name is Sue Wachter, and I'm a customer success consultant for Demi Learning. It's my pleasure to talk to you today about a question that comes up quite often in my consultations with parents. And that's the question of, is it really all that important to learn their facts and know them automatically and not be counting on their fingers or using a number line or something like that? Is it that important? Is it that important to pause and get those taken care of before moving over to the next topic or concept? Let's be honest, you'll find people that will tell you, I'm still counting on my fingers and I have a degree in a math related topic and I was able to get through it. And that can happen. I'm not saying it can't happen. However, too often I'm hearing from parents whose students are struggling anywhere from 8 to 18. And when we take a deep look at it, what we find is that they are still counting on their fingers or using some other counting method to retrieve their fact information. In addition to that, what I find in talking to parents, and I'll keep talking about how I talk to parents, is because that's a learning ground for us around here. That's where we learn the good stuff, is talking to those of you that are actually working with the students. So there's the emotional piece of it. That student knows that they're supposed to know their addition and subtraction and multiplication and division facts. So just that alone becomes an embarrassment for them. And you'll see them trying to hide it even not letting the world know that they're still counting on their fingers or needing a number line. So it's a source of emotional embarrassment. And then what happens then is that embarrassment leads over into their academics, because embarrassment causes anxiety, and anxiety makes it impossible, even if they do know the answer, if they kind of panic and start having that self-talk that says, I'm just not good at this, I'm just not good at math, that then it affects the way that they move forward. And so academically, they begin to struggle a bit. And you're thinking, well, maybe that I'm just not good in math, or maybe they're not just getting the concepts. But so often it relates right back to that they're still trying to retrieve that information on the basic facts to solve a more difficult concept. And what happens is, I'm going to be talking a lot about working memory and referring back to that, is the brain is designed to only have a limited amount of working memory. And so what happens is when the concepts become more complex, the entire working memory is needed to take them through those steps. And when they have to count to add or pause or use some method that takes more than, say, 3 seconds, then what happens is they overload their working memory, and that's where you'll see them just shut down. They know it, and yet they just suddenly just shut down. And some parents will say, well, they're just being lazy or they're not trying hard enough, but that's not necessarily the case. So then there's the whole, do you send them out into life when they're still counting on their fingers and they're trying to make quick decisions in regards to money or other things that involved basic math skills? So let's back up a little bit and talk about the key stages of math development. These are the things that are important to be in place as a student moves forwards and tackles more difficult material and eventually up into the upper level math that they're needing to graduate or go to college or whatever. So the number one step is counting. So the student learns to count, and then they, once they're confident in counting, they understand that those represent objects, they're not just repeating the words, they make that connection, then they're ready for addition and subtraction. And here again, this is where the single digit addition and subtraction come in. And they then that they master that tool. And notice how I'm calling it a tool, because these steps are all tools that are needed to be successful in more complex work. So then after the addition and subtraction becomes the multiplication and then the division. And if students master these tools in order, in the sequence, the confidence also begins to build. So not only are their skills building, but their confidence is building as they're presented with word problems and more advanced math. So let's talk a little bit about where the wheels fall off, because that's where I come into the equation often, is the student is struggling in math and the wheels are falling off and the parent is not sure why. And you often think it's because of the topic at hand. But let's go through and talk about those more advanced subjects and see how they relate back to the fact mastery. So after they've been presented with or learned their single digit, then the student learns multiple digit. Column addition, large numbers, subtracting and adding, borrowing, carrying, regrouping, that type of thing. So as you can see, we're back to that working memory conversation. So in order to process those steps and remember what step comes next and then what's next and you borrow from here and why you borrow from there and all that information, the brain needs that information to process through it. But when they have to revert back to counting to get that single digit fact information, that also requires working memory, because when you're counting to add, you're using working memory, and then your working memory overload happens. Now, I'll be honest, a lot of times you can kind of push through this level without the facts, and you're still working on the facts, and you're using different ways to try to get those facts memorized. The student can still have a certain amount of success often working through multi-digit. For some, this is where the wheels fall off right here, and actually that's a good thing, because now we can address it. Because when the wheels fall off, then we're more willing to step back and say, okay, what do we need to do to get this to be successful? So, but sometimes they're able to kind of push through that, and it's not overloading their working memory enough that they're totally shutting down, and they're experiencing some level of success. So after that, typically the order is multiple digit multiplication. And so, single digit multiplication. So we're back to memorizing again. And it's so fascinating to me, because there will be parents that come to me with older students where they have their multiplication and single digit multiplication and division nailed down, but they're still struggling with those single digit addition and subtraction. And so as they're still struggling, keep in mind, they're also still reinforcing the habits that they're using to get to those answers. But then what happens is when they've got their multiplication facts mastered and now they're presented with multiple digit multiplication, now we are back to needing to use the addition to solve those equations. And so again, that's when you'll see some stress come in, and where they're struggling through, you know that they know the steps, but then when you give them a worksheet with those on it, you see them shutting down and having a struggle getting through. And not only that, now we're mixing together in our word problems, we're doing multi-step word problems where they have to do addition and then subtraction or and then move to multiplication to finally solve the word problem. So then it gets a little messy there. So you think, okay, we're just struggling with word problems. So again, I see people kind of get through this. They're struggling a little, but they're pushing through and they're moving on ahead. However, the big wheels falling off moment often comes with long division. And that's where I get the most calls. That's where the parent is saying, we're long division, and my student just is not able to get through it. They seem to understand the concept. They kind of know the steps, but they get lost along the way. And I'll say, so what you're saying is, if they tell in the conversation, we'll talk about, does the student have the basics? I back up the bus. I say, where are they at with addition subtraction? If they're still counting on their fingers, that's likely the number one cause of what's happening clear up into long division. The problem is now, by this many years, they've well developed their habits that they use to get to that answer. And so what's happening is this working memory overload snowball just gets getting bigger and bigger. And I love that parents call it this stage, because we're still not to, you know, the upper level, the pre-algebra and algebra, where they would be really struggling by then if we don't just address this and take a look at it to find out what we can do to build confidence in their students by getting their math facts mastered. So often at this point, you're thinking, okay, so shall we get the flashcards out, the drill sheets? What shall we do to get this to happen? Usually at this point, both the student and the parents are frustrated, emotional, anxious, and they realize that, okay, we need to get this done. And I'm not saying the flashcards and the drill sheets won't work, but by this point, if they haven't worked, that the habits are pretty ingrained and the strategies you're using aren't working. So this is where the fun begins, because what can happen is we can take a moment and pause and fill in those gaps. And there's nothing more exciting than doing that, and the student begins to gain confidence, the anxiety starts to go away, and things do get better. But the first step is to take an honest evaluation, to pause, and whatever it takes, it's not going to necessarily be a quick phone call where you give us a call and we quickly solve all the problems, but let's take this opportunity to get a good evaluation and get clarity on exactly what your student does and does not know. This is so important, because remember how I referred to addition and subtraction and multiplication as tools? Think about it. So often your student does understand the higher level concept, but they don't have the tools. So it's like, let's say you were really good at working on cars, and you went out to work on the car with your friend, and you get out there and you're handed a butter knife, and your friend gets to use the good tools. So think about it. I mean, even if you're really good at working out cars, it's not going to be any fun. It's just going to be frustrating. It's going to be annoying. It's not going to be something you're going to want to do often. Okay? So it's the same thing with this. Those addition, subtraction, multiplication, division, single digit are tools for success for your student. And without them, often it appears to them that they're just not good in math, just like they'd say, well, I guess I'm just not good working cars because I can't fix it with a butter knife, that type of thing. Now, I want to say right here that if your student is just learning their addition and subtraction facts, that for the first time, it is the primer and alpha levels that you want. However, if your student is older and struggling in math concepts beyond single digit addition subtraction, you may want to start considering that fact mastery could be the cause of this duress. And what I usually recommend, if they're quite older, I'll say just give them maybe a multiplication problem and a division problem, a long division multiplication problem, and observe their behavior. And it's likely that you will see pauses, you will see tapping, you'll see some kind of counting going on that could indicate that your student might benefit from some back mastery. So let's say you do some assessments and you find out your student is still counting and you need to take a look at a different way of approaching fact mastery with your student. Let's talk about how our new product AIM is different than maybe something you've tried before. So first of all, while AIM is a new product, it isn't a new concept for us here at Demi Learning. For the past 25 years, since the beginning when this product hit the market, the Matthew C product, this has been an ongoing conversation that we have had with our parents. And in the past, because it's such a common conversation between the team and working with the parents, and the parents have been incredible. I will have to say the parents are just as much as part of the development of AIM as the team is. And we figured out ways to kind of work around, like use Alpha and work it around to work with an older student. Unfortunately, the most difficult part was that the Alpha material is designed for a younger student. So it was quite obvious to the older student that the materials felt was for a younger child. They felt it was too babyish. But I'm impressed with the hundreds of students that were older and did push through and overlook that it was babyish and helped us by processing through this over the years to get this done using Alpha to help us be ready to develop a new product that is designed for the older student. The babyishness is taken away. The activities are accelerated for a more mature audience. And through this wonderful collaboration with the parents over the years and our team, product development was able to put together this wonderful program that is designed for the older student who does not have mastery of the facts. So what happens is, this is where it does get really exciting, is what happens is when the student is able to be presented with material that appears older but addresses the single digit addition and subtraction, your engagement level is higher. So the higher the student engages, of course, the more they're going to learn. If they're resistant to it and shutting down on you, it's hard to process through the material. So as they engage with this and as they start seeing for themselves that they're having success, the confidence begins to build. Again, hearing back from the customers has been key to this development. And often what we would hear back is, my student is actually getting excited about math. They're starting to show confidence. They're no longer beating themselves up over not being able to memorize the facts. And so the confidence builds and the student begins to stop talking to themselves about how horrible they are in math. And that's where things start getting really exciting. And that's the best news I hear from my customers when we're going through this process. Now, it's not going to be like, okay, say they're 12, and they now have their facts mastered. It's not like, okay, that solves everything. From here, it becomes very individualized. The 12-year-old that now knows their facts, I honestly can't tell you before they know their facts what the next step is. But the way that the Matthew C is designed, it's designed to fill in gaps because we teach in sequential order. So they get their facts mastered, you connect back with us, we do some evaluation, we find the next gap. And because they're older and they are more developed and they do have a lot of math understanding, it doesn't take a whole year to get through a basic concept. And so we'll find that next gap and we'll fill that gap. And sometimes we'll skip levels and sometimes we'll do a fast review of a level, but it's very individualized from there. And so to get your student up to where you want them to be or where you feel their peers are, it may take a year, it may take 6 months, it may take 3 months. We won't know till we get in the process. But the exciting thing is that there is a process, and we have learned through the years by working with each other and the parents, we've found ways to do this. So is AIM going to be a good first step for your student? Well, you may need more information, and that's great. The first step might be just to do an evaluation, and that's on the website. If they're older, I would kind of give them a harder problem and look for evidence that counting and lack of fact mastery may be a problem. If your student's struggling and you're not seeing that, you may want to give us a call. That is our favorite call of the day, is to help a parent begin that process of filling in gaps and helping your student be set up for success mathematically. So I hope that's been enough information to at least pique your interest. It's been my pleasure talking to you. Just remember, we're here to help you. We're here to work alongside you as you desire to set your student up for mathematical success. Thank you for your time today. Hopefully we'll be talking to you soon.